Hi friends, once again welcome back in our educational channel, that is Precise Electronics. Friends, from today's video lecture, we are going to start a new topic, that is operational amplifier. And in today's video lecture, we are going to study characteristics of perfect amplifier and the characteristics of operational amplifier. First of all, amplifier. What is amplifier? Amplifier is an electronic circuit which is used to increase the strength of weak signal, but frequency and the shape of that signal remain constant. That means amplifier increases the amplitude of input signal, amplitude of weak signal, but the frequency and the shape remain constant. That is amplifier. Perfect amplifier or ideal amplifier. The perfect amplifier is the amplifier which has following characteristics, and the characteristics are now going to display on your screen. The first characteristics, that is infinite gain. Friend, what is gain? Gain is the ratio of output to the input, or output is equal to gain into input. Gain, that is A is equal to V0 upon VI. Therefore, V0 is equal to A times that of VI. So output, that is V0, is equal to A into VI. What is A? A is the gain. So output signal will depend upon the gain of that amplifier as well as the input signal. As gain of the amplifier is very high, a small change in input signal produces a sufficient change in output signal. If there is a very small change in input potential, input signal, we are getting a sufficient change in output signal. That is because of the gain. That is first characteristics. What is second characteristics? The second characteristics is infinite input impedance. Impedance, that is Z. That is ZI. I stand for input. Impedance is measured in ohm. So impedance is also known as resistance. As with input impedance is very high, a small change in input signal, if there is a small change in input current, getting a sufficient change in output signal. Because V is equal to IR, that is by using Ohm's law, we know that V is equal to IR. That means V is equal to R means the resistance, R means the impedance. If impedance is very high, there is a small change in current. If current varies in some microampere, in nanoampere, but as impedance is very high, we are getting a sufficient input parameter, input voltage, because V is equal to IR, and that input voltage can be easily amplified, or it is faithfully amplified to get a sufficient output voltage. That means due to infinite input impedance, a small change in signal, a small signal can be faithfully amplified, and we are getting sufficient output signal. That is second characteristics, input impedance. The third characteristics is output impedance. Output impedance, that is given by ZO. Output impedance is low, it is a zero. In case of perfect amplifier, the output impedance is zero. So zero output impedance. Due to zero output impedance, if load resistance drop to zero, suppose due to short circuited, suppose there are some accidents, and due to accident, the load connected to that output terminus gets short circuited. That means the resistance of that circuit drops to zero, it will not affect the output voltage. It will not affect the optimal condition of amplifier. So output remain constant. So due to these characteristics, if load resistance drops to zero, the output voltage or output signal remains constant. That is the third characteristic, zero output impedance. Now the fourth characteristics, that is zero output when input is zero. Means if input is absent, there should be no output. Obviously there is no input, there should be no output. The ordinary amplifier or practical amplifier introduce its AC and DC signal, and due to which we are getting output signal. as input is absent, there is no input signal, the output signal must be zero. So amplifier should not introduce any AC or DC signal to produce output signal. Zero input, output may be zero. Next, infinite bandwidth, the next characteristics, that is infinite bandwidth. What is bandwidth? Bandwidth, it is actually a difference between a higher frequency range and lower frequency range. As it has infinite bandwidth, this amplifier can be easily amplified, it can be faithfully amplified of different frequency range signals. The signals having different frequency ranges. That means it can be easily amplified the low frequency signal as well as the high frequency signals. That means due to infinite bandwidth, the signal with different frequencies can be faithfully amplified. The signal with different frequencies, the low frequency signals as well as very high frequency signals can be easily amplified, can be faithfully amplified by using this amplifier, by using this perfect amplifier or by using the ideal amplifier. The next, the amplifier must be insensitive to supply fluctuation as well as the temperature variation. Supply fluctuation means supply variation, means if the supply voltage get varied, if the operating supply voltage is operating potential, that is nothing but the biasing potential. If the biasing potential get varied or even the temperature get varied, it will not affect the operating condition. So output will not depend upon the supply variation or temperature variation. Output will only depend upon the input signal. So this amplifier, that ideal amplifier, must be insensitive to supply variation, supply fluctuation or temperature variation. So these are the characteristics of ideal amplifier or a perfect amplifier. But friends, unfortunately, the amplifier used in electronic appliances, that is a practical amplifiers, are not able to fulfill all these characteristics. These amplifier are also has some drawbacks, and these drawbacks are, the first drawback in case of RC coupled amplifier. First of all, what is coupled amplifier? If output of one amplifier is connected to the input of other amplifier, some coupling device are required. Means output of one stage is connected to the input of other stage by using some components. These components are known as coupling components, and these amplifiers known as coupled amplifier. In case of RC coupled, the resistors and capacitors are used to connect the output of one stage to the input of other stage. So the output of one stage is connected to the input of other stage by using the resistors and capacitor, then this amplifier is known as RC coupled amplifier. What is the drawback of RC coupled amplifier? At stage, RF means radio frequency, that means very high. If the very high frequency signal is applied, then this device, this amplifier, will not work properly. That RC coupled will not work properly. That is drawback of RC coupled amplifier. At very low frequency or at very high frequency, at very low frequency and very high frequency, the gain of the amplifier decreases. As the gain decreases, output also decreases. So at low frequency and at high frequency, the gain of the amplifier decreases. And one more drawback of this amplifier is that this amplifier is unable to amplify DC signal faithfully. It is unable to amplify the DC signal faithfully. That is one of the main drawback of RC coupled. The next amplifier is a transformer coupled amplifier. In transformer coupled amplifier, output of one amplifier is connected to the input terminal of other amplifier by using transformer. That's why it is known as a transformer coupled amplifier. So what's the drawbacks of transformer coupled amplifier? That is, as transformer is used for the coupling purpose, the size, shape, weight and the cost. So these are the drawbacks of transformer coupled amplifier. as transform is used, the size, weight, cost are increases. The one more drawback, or the main drawback of transformer power amplifier, is that the losses and leakages. In transformer, there are two types of losses, that is copper loss and core loss. And due to these losses, the output signal is less than the input signal. It is not equal to the applied input signal. The frequency response of this transformer copper amplifier is also not uniform. It will get varied. That means the output signal also get varied. So these are the drawback of transformer copper amplifier. That is size, shape, cost increases. Then due to losses, we are not getting the sufficient output to the input stage of next amplifier. And the frequency response of transformer copper amplifier is also not uniform. The next type of coupled amplifier is direct coupled amplifier. What is direct coupled amplifier? In which the output of one stage is directly connected to the input of other stage. There is no coupling components. But in this case, the variation in temperature affects the operating condition. The temperature gets varied, the operating condition gets varied. And if AC signal is applied, mostly amplifiers are used to amplify the AC signal. If AC input is applied, DC components are also appeared in output signal. Means DC signal are not get bypassed. The DC signals are also appears in that output signal. That means the output is distorted. The noise. Noise means it is unwanted electric signal. The noise is also interferes in the operation. That means external electric signal, unwanted electric signal is also introduced, and due to which the output get fluctuated. The output not remain constant, it will get varied. So these are the drawbacks of practical amplifiers or ordinary amplifiers. To remove all these drawbacks, to eliminate this drawback, the one more amplifier is designed, and that is known as operational amplifier. So obviously operational amplifier must be almost fulfill the characteristics of ideal amplifier or perfect amplifier. Now we are going towards the characteristics of operational amplifier. First, in case of ordinary amplifier, gain is not sufficient high, but in case of operational amplifier, it has high gain, almost infinite. It has high gain due to which a small change in input produces a sufficient change in output. So first characteristics of operational amplifier, high gain. Second, it has high input impedance. May compared to ordinary amplifier, the input impedance of op-amp is very high. Next, it has low output impedance. So due to low output impedance, if output resistance drop to zero, it will not affect the output condition. It will not affect the operating conditions. Next, it has ability to amplify both AC and DC signal faithfully. That is very important. This amplifier, that is operational amplifier, can be able to amplify both AC signal and DC signal faithfully. It is used in both analog and digital field. Analog field means a field in which a continuous varying signal is applied. A continuous varying signal means audio signal or video signals are continuous varying signal. So these signals are applied, that is known as an analog signal. It is an analog field or analog instrument. And digital means in which the signal has constant voltage and constant frequency. That signals are known as the digital signals. Digital signals are mostly given in form of 0 and 1. And when that signals, which has a constant frequency and constant amplitude, is applied to this amplifier, it is known as a digital signal. So this amplifier, that is operational amplifier, is used in both analog and digital field. Next, due to common mode rejection, this amplifier has ability to remove the common signal, common mode signal. And due to rejection of common mode signal, there is no noise and trip. Noise means it is unwanted signal, unwanted electric signal. So there is no noise. So noise get removed. In ordinary amplifier, due to noise, the operation get deflected. It will get fluctuate. We are not getting a constant output. But in operation amplifier, as this noise get removed, the common mode signal get removed. There is no noise and there is no trip. Trip means variation. There is no variation. Output signal remain constant. Will get constant. Next, it is used in both. It is used to perform mathematical operations such as addition, subtraction, multiplication, integration. It is used to perform the derivation. That means this circuit can be used as adder, subtractor, integrator, differentiator. This amplifier is known as operational amplifier. It is used to perform the mathematical operation. And as it is used to perform the mathematical operation, this amplifier is known as operational amplifier. Next, in operational amplifier, as coupling devices are not used, there is no coupling devices, this amplifier can be easily fabricated in IC. This amplifier can be easily fabricated on IC. So due to which the size of that amplifier, the cost, weight get reduced. So as these amplifiers are available in IC form, the shape, weight, cost, size get reduced. Next, operating condition of this amplifier does not affect due to supply fluctuation and the temperature variation. Operating condition will depends, mean operate output potential, mostly the output potential will depends upon the input signal. It will not depends upon the temperature variation as well as the biasing voltage, that is the supply voltage. So it will not affect the operating condition. Last but not least, this amplifier is basically high gain DC amplifier. High gain, it has a very high gain. And this amplifier can be faithfully amplify the DC signal. That's why it is known as a high gain DC amplifier. That is operation amplifier. That is introduction of operation amplifier. Next video lecture, we are going to study the block diagram of operation amplifier and the pin configuration as well as the pin diagram of operation amplifier. So friends, keep watching these video lectures. Bye. Take care. See you again.